Before we begin, I'd like to welcome everyone to our 4 p.m. Mass. Also, to anyone who is in the parking lot listening, welcome as well. And those who will be watching this online, welcome. So let us start. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. My brothers and sisters, as we acknowledge our sins so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path. Give all who, for the faith they profess, are accounted Christians, the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ, and to strive after all that does it honor. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "If only you would heed the voice of our Lord your God and keep his commandments and statutes that are written in this book of the law, when you return to the Lord your God with all your heart and all your soul. For this command that I enjoin on you today is not too mysterious and remote for you. It is not up in the sky that you should say, who will go up to the sky and get it for us and tell us of it, that we may carry it out? Nor is it across the sea that you should say, who will cross the sea and get it for us and tell us of it, that we may carry it out? No, it is something very near to you, already in your mouths and in your hearts. You have only to carry it out." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Turn to the Lord in your need, and you will live. You will live. I pray to you, O Lord, for the time of your favor, O God. In your great kindness, answer me with your constant help. Answer me, O Lord, for bounteous is your kindness. In your great mercy, turn toward me. Turn to the Lord in your need, and you will live. I am afflicted and in pain. Let your saving help, O God, protect me. I will praise the name of God in song, and I will glorify him with thanksgiving. Turn to the Lord in your need, and you will live. Seeing you lowly ones, and be glad. You who seek God, may your hearts revive. For the Lord hears the poor, in his own word, in his own who are in bonds, he spurns not. Turn to the Lord in your need, and you will live. For God will save Zion and rebuild the cities of Judea. The descendants of his servants shall inherit it, and those who love his name shall inhabit it. Turn to the Lord in your need, and you will live. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Christ Jesus is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For in him were created all things in heaven and on earth, the visible and the invisible, whether thrones or dominions or principalities or powers. All things were created through him and for him. He is before all things, and in him all things hold together. He is the head of the body, the church. He is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in all things he himself might be preeminent. For in him all the fullness was pleased to dwell, and through him to reconcile all things for him, making peace by the blood of his cross. Through him, whether those on earth or those in heaven. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel according to Luke. There was a scholar of the law who stood to test Jesus and said, "Teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?" Jesus said to him, "What is written in the law? How do you read it?" He said in reply, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your being, with all your strength, and with all your mind, and your neighbor as yourself." He replied to him, "You have answered correctly. Do this, and you will live." But because he wished to justify himself, he said to Jesus, "And who is my neighbor?" Jesus replied, "A man fell victim to robbers as he went from Jerusalem to Jericho. They stripped and beat him and went off, leaving him half dead. A priest happened to be going down the road, but when he saw him, he passed by on the other side. Likewise, a Levite came to the place, and when he saw him, he passed on by the other side. But a Samaritan traveler who came upon him was moved with compassion at the sight. He approached the victim, poured oil and wine over his wounds, and bandaged them. Then he lifted him up on his own animal, took him to an inn, and cared for him. The next day, he took 2 silver coins and gave them to the innkeeper with the instructions, 'Take care of him. If you spend more than what I have given you, I shall repay you on the way back.' Which of these 3, in your opinion, was neighbor to the robber's victim?" He answered, "The one who treated him with mercy." Jesus said to him, "Go and do likewise." The Gospel of the Lord.
Good evening, brothers and sisters in Christ. When Jesus was challenged about what was the greatest commandment, he certainly answered, "But you know, you wonder what the rabbi, the Levites, the Pharisees, and the scribes, you know, they all profess this love of God, but it's not in their hearts. It wasn't in any of their hearts." And even though, you know, they tested the Jesus and the scholar who was there. And then Jesus gives this wonderful parable about who truly loves, you know, their neighbor. You know, when we think of the poor man that was on the side of the road dying, nobody really cared about him. Nobody knows who he was. And maybe he was beaten by robbers and left to die. Whatever the situation, the priest certainly didn't want to touch the guy. Unclean, if I touch this guy, I'll have to, you know, purify myself. And the same with the Levite. It was the Samaritan who disregarded, you know, all kinds of barriers to show some kindness, some charity, and to show this love. To save this man, no matter who he really was. You know, I think the priest and the Levite certainly failed in brotherly love. It certainly wasn't there. And the Samaritan, of course, goes way beyond, you know, the boundary here by taking him to town and giving 2 coins to make sure that he survives and lives. But you know, when you think of this whole story, we might ask ourselves, you know, do we love as the Samaritan loved? Do we love our neighbor? Are we willing to just, you know, go a little ways to love, to show kindness, mercy, whatever it might be? I think a real good way of looking at this, and it's a very spiritual way of looking at it, how Jesus, who came into the world, you know, how he looked upon humanity. You know, it's dying in its own sin. It's like a man by the side of the road dying and dead almost. And Jesus doesn't walk by and ignore humanity. He doesn't just let it go. Instead, he takes humanity, he takes the cross out of love, out of love, and dies on it to save us. And what he does leave us, you know, those two coins that the Samaritan, you know, had left for the innkeeper to take care of that guy. Well, the Lord Jesus left the church and the sacraments as those two coins to take care of us. I think that's a really good way of looking at how the Lord loved every single person on earth. Or else he would have made a distinction, but he didn't. He did come for his own people, but he also opened it up to the Gentiles. All peoples, all nations, all cultures, all races. And yet we struggle trying to love our brothers in whatever nation or whatever culture or whatever race. It seems to be a struggle for us. We are more like the scholar. We know what's right and wrong, but we don't take it to heart as Jesus took it to heart as he went to the cross and died and took sin to himself and suffering. Truly, there is, you know, the greatest example of somebody saving humanity if they want to be saved. He opened up the gates of heaven for everybody to come, the chance and the possibility for people to enter the gate of heaven by his death on that cross. So you can make a little parallel there with the Lord. But I think we're always challenged by this gospel of how much we want to be a good Samaritan. It doesn't take much. It takes a little smile, a little hello, a little handshake. It goes a long way to extending just that wonderful and good demeanor. And when that wonderful and good demeanor's out there, then you have a sense of, you know, acceptance. But if we go, you know, with a big old frown, I'm just a hard, crusty old man, tough as nails, and I don't care about anybody. That's what you get in the world, in the workplace. And those who have no values, they struggle. They don't care. It's all about me, myself, and I. And God forbid anybody else get in the way. That's the world we live in. I think all of you working people know that. But the Lord is calling us not to go in that direction, to take the road that Jesus took, the suffering, the sacrifice. And, you know, the Samaritan, of course, that maybe he'll see the man in the future, but we know that Jesus will see the faithful in the future. All of us that are faithful will see the Lord God in eternal life. And you know, that is what we're all looking forward to. So we ask the Lord God to give us the strength to persevere in our relationships, especially outside of the church. When somebody offends us, to forgive and to forget, and to be that good Samaritan when somebody's in trouble, whatever the trouble might be. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us stand to profess our faith.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, and God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray.
We pray that the Church may show the love of God by the active love of neighbors. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the lonely, aged, and infirmed in our society will not be ignored or passed by. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Highland Park shooting victims, their families, and community, and that there will be no more of these tragic events. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to abortion, euthanasia, terrorism, and all acts that harm the dignity of the human person, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase in vocations to the priesthood and religious life, especially from within our own archdiocese, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick in our daily prayers, that God's healing touch may bring them peace and comfort, especially Rose Carvajal, Julia and Teresa Gonzalez, and Virginia D'Alessandro, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the souls of the faithfully departed. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Special intentions for this evening's Mass are for our beloved dead, for the repose of the souls of Martha Huntington, Louise Snyder, and Elodia Valdez. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God the Father of mercies, hear our prayers and petitions. We ask them in faith, and we ask them through our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Please join in singing worship hymnal 890, By All Your Saints Still Striving, worship hymnal 890.
To
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Look upon the offerings of the Church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you, and grant that, when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who
therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and John, our Archbishop, and all those who hold to the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants. And all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you, for them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help through Christ our Lord. Amen. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen through Christ our Lord. Amen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar and heart, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body of God and your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith, and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace, through Christ our Lord. Amen. To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Thank you. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
join in singing worship hymnal 923, Come to the Banquet, worship hymnal 923.
Come to the banquet, come to the feast, eat the bread of life, share in the singing, share in the joy, drink the cup of love. Draw near and take the body of the Lord, and drink with faith.
Let us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow through Christ our Lord. Three announcements. All high school teens, please join us for Life Team called Illuminate on Sunday, July the 10th at 5 p.m. in the parish hall. We will play Grow in the Dark games followed by dinner. Make sure you wear a black clothing. We are looking for volunteers for the Sacristan, Donut, Cleaning, and Landscape Ministries. Please see the bulletin for more information. There will be a rosary sale Saturday, July the 16th. It's next Saturday from 3 p.m. to 6 p.m. in the prayer garden. Holy Communion rosaries and Holy Communion chaplets will also be available for purchase. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in singing worship hymnal 968, The Master Came to Bring Good News, worship hymnal 968.